Hello lovely, welcome back to my channel. My name's Shahad if you don't know me already. And for today's video, I'm super excited. This is a video I've wanted to do for a little while, but also I've kind of pushed it back. And so here it is, it's finally spooky season and I'm so excited for it. I've decorated my background, I'm in love with spooky season and I love Halloween, one of my favorite holidays, and so I had to do a video for it. And so for today's video, it's something along the lines of 10 last minute Halloween DIY costumes for all occasions, not just Halloween. Disclaimer, everything came from my closet. So everything you're gonna see in this video is literally from my closet. I opened my closet and there were the clothes. The only things I bought was like the witch's hat or like the vampire's cape, like very minimal propping. The rest, makeup and everything I had at home. So I'm pretty sure you guys can, if this is a last minute, fast decision that you have to make, then this is the right place to be. So I have timestamps below. You can skip to different characters. Two sections in this video. I have the Halloween-ish section, which is the Halloween classics, but then I also have the TV slash movie slash books characters, but all the character timestamps are linked down below, so just click in the description to if you want to skip ahead to a certain character. And yeah, so without further ado, let's get into the first spooky costume.
A step outside and seize the day now.
Wednesday, Addams. Now this is the look I prepared for her. Now my forehead is small compared to the picture of her, which shows her having a long forehead, but I don't mind. And so then I have the makeup. Now the makeup isn't exactly what she wears. This is a little bit more dramatic, but I have the lipstick, the pink lipstick, then I have the dark eyeshadow, I have some fake lashes and a winged liner. And yeah, it isn't the exact same. Then I have her hair and I try to do this wave thing. It isn't exactly symmetrical, but I don't mind. And so yeah, then I have the pigtails, the classic pigtails on her. I actually have long hair, so these pigtails are really long. Then I have the collared neck, which I used my school shirt for, and put it under. And then on top, I have the dress. Now this is a skin tight dress I got from Valley Girl. It isn't exactly black, but it works. And I also have the leggings. So this is the leggings. They're just black plain leggings, and these are the shoes that I have. They're just literally my black school shoes and they work perfectly. And then I have the skull, which is a propping, which I have for Wednesday. Since I don't have the poisoned bottle that she loves, I have a skull, which goes with the theme. And yeah, that's the look. Sandy Olson. Here is Sandy's makeup. It's a casual look. I have some dark eyeshadow with some wing liner, have some fake lashes, and then I also have the pop of a red, as that is the red lipstick for her lips, which is the classic. Here are the eyes and the liner, and then I also done my hair. Now my hair I didn't curl it properly. I didn't have a wig, so instead I just used my normal hair and I just tied it back and put a clip at the back, and it's kind of curly wavy, so I thought that would work. Two strands, put it back, so it's out of my face. And then I have my top, which is short at the arms, but it isn't off the shoulder. It's a round circle neck, but that's still okay. Then I have the leggings, which are clear and shiny, so I use them. And here are the shoes. They are low heels. They are shiny and black, and they are perfect for this outfit. And yeah, here is Sandy from Greece. Black Kitty Cat. So here is the kitty cat costume. Now here is the makeup. I twisted the costume from the Grease costume. So if you haven't seen that already, then go ahead and see it. And so here's the makeup, the same makeup. I only increased the eyeliner to make it more cat-eyed. So yeah, have the classic red lip and everything as well. The hair is the same as well. I just tied two strands back. The rest of my hair is out. It is sort of curly, not really, but here it is back. I just tied everything back. Or you could do it as a ponytail if you like to, or two pigtails, either one works. And so yeah, here's the hair. And so then on top of that, I have a kitty cat ears. Now I have a white one here, but if you wanted to, you can use a black one. I actually made this at home, so that's why I had this and so I use it. There we go. And so yeah, that's the cute look of the makeup and hair together with the cat ears. And so here is the bomber jacket. Now I got this bomber jacket very recently from BOOHOO, and I have a video of it. If you haven't watched it already, click right up here to watch it. Very recent. And then here it is. Ooh, and then I have the dress under. So this is the dress. It's a black dress, nothing fancy, just a branded black dress. Any black dress would work. And so that is what I have. And then I have this belt. I have a thick belt around my waist. And then on the back of the belt, it is the smaller belt. And that smaller belt is the tail. Here it is. I have a black belt, and I put it at the back like that. That's how I attached it. And so then that's the tail. And then I have these fishnet leggings, which work nicely with this costume. And then I have black shoes. You can use any shoes you'd like. And here are the black ones. I've got these ones, like the black boots. I think they're very, very fancy for this costume. And yeah, that's the full look complete. The witch. Here is the witch's costume. Now I have my makeup done. The makeup is really pretty. It's purple ombre effect from blue white all the way to dark purple with the eyeliner and with three dots to add the stars and mystical effect to it. Here is the eyeshadow look. And then I also have my hair. Now this hair is just all out. I just put a little bit back and tied it back at the end so it doesn't go drop in my face, but I feel like for a witch that would be nice if it was out. Now I have this dress. It's a black dress, but I got this from BOOHOO, so if you like to check it out, the description is up there. It's actually see-through, and so under it I wore another dress which is black, and you can wear any color dress you'd like to under it. Here is the purple hat. I did purple eyeshadow with the purple witch's hat. So yeah, there's a dress under this other dress which I put on top, so it's really beautiful. Any dress would work. And so yeah, I use these shoes. These shoes are also the ones I used for Grease, Sandy. They're really, really nice. They are pointy, which is something that a witch would love to wear, and shiny, and really, really comfy, and they're low-heeled, so they're really, really cute and easy to use. And then you can have this. I bought this as well. This is $4 from Woolworths or Coles or whatever supermarket you have. They're just striped stockings, and you could wear those shoes under them. I didn't wear them because I didn't need to. And then here is the broomstick. Now, I actually don't have a broomstick, and so I'm dancing with this cleaning equipment that I had found in my closet. It's from Dettol. So thank you, Dettol. I also added a little bit of personalization with this purple ribbon around my waist and on the broom, so they match. Yay! And so here is the final costume.
Honestly, this is one of my favorite costumes. It's so cute and so pretty and comfy and just works for the spooky season.
Valma Dinkley. Valma's costume. Now I have my makeup. It's very, very simple. Just some eyeshadow. I've added some orangish brownish eyeshadow, and then I've also added some blush, some fake freckles, and a little bit of lip gloss that doesn't look like there's anything on there. And so for my hair, I don't actually have a fringe or a wig, so what I did is I got the front and then tied it at the back with bobby pins, put it behind my ear, and put my hair on top so it hides it. I don't have short hair, so I can't really do anything. I don't even have a wig. I can't cut it, so I'm just gonna keep it like this. It doesn't look as accurate to the character, but you can have a wig if you want to. I also have some glasses, have no lens inside of it, but if you have lens for glasses, it's absolutely fine to use as well. So these are fake ones. And then I have this orange, bright orange shirt. I'm surprised I found this in my closet. I'm sure many of you don't have this, but very, very bright shirt that's long sleeved, and that was perfect. And so then under it, I actually have a dress. This is a red dress. You need a skirt under it, but this red dress worked perfectly fine. Like, it looks like a skirt, it doesn't even look like a dress. And so I put that under the orange. Then I also have these, which is actually paper. I don't have the orange socks, so instead I just use orange paper and tied it to the back. That worked perfectly fine as well. And then I have these red maroon shoes. They aren't completely red, but they're maroon. But they're really, really cute, and I thought they would be perfect to tie in the costume all together.
So yeah, that is Valma's costume. It's plain and simple, but really, really nice and good for something that is last minute. Here is Kim Possible's outfit. Now this is her makeup. Her makeup has a lot of dark eyeshadow, but it's also very pinky, peachy. It has an ombre effect, and there's also eyeliner all around her eyes, which I put to highlight her eyes. And then I also put lipstick, which is dark red maroon brownish lipstick, which is on the top lip only. And then some blush, so it's more coming at you, looking more cartoony. And then the lower lip is also foundation is on the lower lip, so that it doesn't show that there's any lips. Like, that's how Kim Possible's outfit is. Her hair is on a side part. That's how my hair is also. I don't have ginger hair, but my hair is going to keep it like this. I don't have a wig either, so this is the last minute I have. It works, so it doesn't matter. And so the top I have, I used it for one of my other costumes. I'm pretty sure it's for Grease. But just like Kim Possible, it's short on the arms, and it isn't full turtleneck, but it is a circle top as well. But yeah, there's enough space just like Kim's clothes. And then there's some black gloves, which is what she has as well. These are cotton ones, you can use leather ones, either ones work. And then I have the pants. Now these pants are really, really cool. They are green cargo pants. I actually stole them from my brother to use for this costume, so thank you, Ashkan. And so yeah, I have those. They're really, really cool. They fit nicely. And then I have this brown belt. Now I don't have the fanny pack that she does, but I have a brown belt which I turned around and used as the fanny pack thingy. Fanny pack. I think this works either way, especially for something so last minute. Yeah, so that works with the pants. And so that works with the pants. And then I have the shoes. Now the shoes are black, plain shoes. Nothing interesting. I literally bought them for like $5 from Target. They'll work perfectly fine. And so yeah, that is Kim Possible's outfit. Katniss Everdeen. And so here is Katniss's costume. Now the makeup, don't worry about it, it's completely wrong. And the shirt is supposed to be a black shirt, but I don't have one, so I just have this one that says Scorpio on it. And then I have this bomber jacket, which I used for my other costumes for as well. I have the boots, which are also wrong. They are meant to be other boots, but they're meant to be flat boots. These ones have heels on them, so these ones are not the correct ones. But what is correct about this is probably the jacket, the hair, not the makeup, but the pants as well, the green cargo pants. I would say for Katniss, natural makeup is perfect. This one was just the makeup look from the other previous costume. So yeah, that is her look. It's very plain, very simple. I don't have the bow either, but I am faking having the bow, so you can fake having the bow. But yeah, so it's very simple. All you need is the propping of the bow, which I do not have, and a few plain pieces of clothing, which I'm sure you could find in your closet. And there we go, Katniss Everdeen.
Peter. If you're a Hunger Games fan, then give this video a thumbs up. Comment that down below, because I've read the Hunger Games and would love to see your opinion on it. I love the Hunger Games so much. Read the books before I watched the films, and the films are amazing just as well as the books, and the books are so good.
Dot Warner. Some of you might not know who she is, but she is a 90s cartoon character. And so I thought if you had a 90s themed day, this would be a cute character to play. So, yeah. Let's begin with this makeup look. Now this makeup look is makeup. I actually didn't have any face paint, so I did all with makeup. So I put white on my face with a white eyeshadow. You can use face paint also. I painted on her nose with that little white highlight. I painted on the eyes and the mouth. And then I have this little yellow flower, which I put on top and tied my hair back in a ponytail. Yes, and then I have these shirt. I don't have a turtleneck, but it is long sleeved, so I thought this would work. I also have the skirt. This is a pink satin skirt. It's like a silky satin pattern. I don't have the white gloves, but you could paint your hand white if you wanted to. And then, yeah, it's really cute. And then I have some black leggings, just simple black leggings. And then under, I have the white shoes. This is from Nike. They are very, very pretty and very comfortable. So this outfit is a very comfy one. And yeah, it's really, really pretty. And I think these work perfectly with it. You can wear any white shoes, honestly. You can wear fashionable ones or these, but these work perfectly. So yeah, this is her outfit. Mean Girls. Now please excuse me, I have hiccups, but here is my makeup look. I've gone for a pinkish puppy makeup look. I got inspired by the Mean Girls film and the pink that they love to have. And so yeah, I have the pink makeup, eyeshadow and lipstick, which are prominent. I have my hair tied back in a ponytail and then with a cheetah print scrunchie so it matches. I have this beautiful custom necklace, and then I have this white shirt, but I put a bobby pin in between it so it's not a lot of cleavage. But if you like to show cleavage, then go ahead. And then I have this skirt, which is actually from my mom, which is very, very cute. It's big, but it's really cute. And then I have these fishnet leggings, which work nicely with the look. And then I have these pink shoes. They are mini heels, very, very mini, and they wrap around my leg, which gives it a very nice look. And then I have this notepad, which is not really a notepad, it's a diary. It's a 2019 diary, which I actually have things written in, which is very, very funny. And yeah, here is the look. P.S. This is an absolute replica of a character outfit from the Mean Girls, but this is just inspired from the Mean Girls.
The Vampire. So here is the vampire. Now here is my makeup. I actually use face paint and makeup. So the face paint is the white because I couldn't get my makeup to be as white. And then I did the dark eyeshadow with my eyeshadow and my lips to match the eyes and tie it all in together and make it all spooky. I have the drool coming down my mouth as well for blood. And then I have these pigtails. I got inspired from the Wednesday costume, and so I just kept it in. And so here I have a scarf. I literally have a scarf for it. It's like just a random scarf my mom had, so you can use that instead of buying a cape. And I also have this dress. Now this dress is also made of like scarfy material, so I thought it would match with the cape nicely. You can use any black dress, honestly, anything's nice, but I would recommend a long dress for a vampire because that would suit it best. And then I have these boots. These are the same boots I use for the kitty cat costume. Just some platform boots. They're just the different kinds, sorry. And so here it is. Yeah, really, really cute. And that is the full spooky outfit.
And that's the video, you guys. I hope you enjoyed. I know I had so much fun filming it. I'll put my favorite right here, which costume was my favorite. Follow my Instagram because I'm going to post photos of the costumes if you'd like to get a better look. And I hope you enjoyed. If you found this video very useful or insightful, please give it a thumbs up. It would help me so much to know what kind of videos you guys like. And so if you'd like to see more of them, please give it a thumbs up so I know. Comment down below other video ideas you'd like to see me do. And also comment down below, Katniss or Peter, if you know the Hunger Games. Wink, wink. And subscribe, hitting the notification button to be notified every time I post a new video. There will also be spontaneous posts on my channel when I feel like it. And I will be doing more of this in the future. So if you'd like to stick around, then please subscribe. I would love to have you be along on my journey. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a spooky Halloween and the rest of your day. I'll see you guys later. Peace, my lovelies. Boo.